Hello. So today we will talk about genes and proteins and how molecular weight changes when a gene is expressed in form of RNA or protein. So before that, we should know that all the functions of a biological system which are known to science, most of them, they are governed by genes only. So genes is basically segment of DNA which encode for a RNA. That RNA may be messenger RNA, transfer RNA, ribosomal RNA, or any other kind of small RNA. If it's a messenger RNA is translated into protein form. So today we'll talk how mass changes when a gene, a segment of DNA, is finally converted into its product RNA and eventually into protein. So according to a central dogma, a gene is converted into RNA by a process called transcription. In transcription, the sequence of DNA is converted into RNA sequence. This RNA could be a messenger RNA, transfer RNA, ribosomal, or any other kind of RNA. And if we look at the function, gene is a nucleotide sequence, DNA is a nucleotide sequence. So nucleotide sequence or gene itself has no function, it has no role to play until it gets converted into its product. The product is, final product may be RNA or the protein. The final product is protein only when the gene is encoding for messenger RNA. So now you look at the molecule weight of the components. In case of DNA, the average molecule weight of a nucleotide, DNA we know is a duplex DNA which forms by two strands, by base pairs. So one nucleotide, the average molecule weight is 330 Dalton. If you talk about base pair, because there are two strands in DNA, so base pair will have double of 330, is 660 Dalton. And one more thing we should know here, when a protein is translated from DNA sequence, each amino acid of protein is encoded by triplet of nucleotides of DNA, which you call codon. It means you require three consecutive nucleotides of DNA, which encode a single amino acid in protein. So one codon, the molecule weight, average molecule weight of one codon means triplet of nucleotide sequence which encode for a single amino acid is 1980 Dalton average molecular weight. Then this sequence of DNA is converted into RNA. The process, you know, is called transcription. In case of RNA, RNA is generally single-stranded mostly. So in case of RNA, the average base of a nucleotide is 340 Dalton. So similarly, the three nucleotide of RNA will make one codon, which will code for single amino acid in protein. So one codon of RNA will have mass, average mass of 1020 Dalton. Now, if this RNA is messenger RNA means the final product has got to be protein amino acid sequence in form of protein. So when the messenger RNA is formed from gene, the messenger RNA is converted into amino acid sequence by a process called translation, where ribosomes helps in this process. So in case of, and the protein is synthesized. In protein, the average mass of a single amino acid, average mass of single amino acid is 110 Dalton. So you see here how mass is being changed. So One codon is 1980 Dalton. In case of gene DNA, the same is converted into RNA, the average mass is 1020 Dalton. And when the same codon is converted into amino acid in form of protein, the mass is reduced to 110 Dalton, the average mass. So it's a very common question asked in biological sciences, molecular biology, which is bigger in size, a gene or the product of the gene, which may be RNA or protein. So it's clear from here, the mass of one amino acid is 110 Dalton, which is formed from 1020 Dalton of RNA. And this 1020 Dalton is basically coming from 1980 Dalton mass of DNA sequence. It means DNA is always bigger in size than the product RNA and the protein. So if you look at their ratio will be DNA, RNA and protein 1980 to 1020 to 110. Okay, so if you compare ratio of masses of amino acid, RNA and DNA sequence, you will see that one amino acid, the ratio of amino acid in protein to RNA to DNA is 1:9:18. It means the DNA gene is on average 18 times larger than the protein. And if you talk about RNA, RNA is 9 times larger to the amino acid sequence of the protein.